And welcome to Hollywood Revue, brought to you by King's Cannabiz, with your hostess, Denise Harris. So sit back and enjoy. We're going to be talking about the 10 top box office this past week. Bet you can't guess which one is number one. We'll be right back.
Go on. I was not myself, and you were someone else. I'd say so much to you, and I would tell the truth, 'cause I can hardly breathe when your hands let go of me. The ice is thinning out, and my feet brace themselves. I'm there. You've seen this hole before, life left on the shore. We're smiling all the same. You sail away again. I'm there.
Okay, let's get to it. The top 10 movies in the box office this past week. Of course, number one is what? Endgame. Woohoo! Yes, indeedy. It looks like it's going to be number one this next week also. 95% tomato meter, 92 audience. Hells yeah. I did not get to see it this week, so Tuesday I am going hell or high water. I already got the ticket. So, I am going Tuesday. So, I will let you know. I've heard nothing but good about it. So, I hope you've seen it. Of course, the critics love it. Exciting, entertaining, emotionally impactful. Endgame does whatever it takes to deliver a satisfying finale to Marvel's epic Infinity Saga. Oh, yeah. And as I announced the other night, it's broken, of course, all box office records. It is the number one box office movie, period. Number one of all of them. So, congrats for that. Of course, we know what it's about. But if you don't, the grave course of events set in motion by Thanos that wiped out half the universe and fractured the Avengers ranks compels the remaining Avengers to take one final stand in the grand conclusion to 22 films, Avengers Endgame. And of course, Robert Downey Jr., Chris Evans, Iron Man, Captain America, Mark Ruffalo as Bruce Banner, the Hulk, Chris Hemsworth, Thor, Scarlett Johansson, Black Widow, Jeremy Renner, Hawkeye, yes. So, yes, definitely a must-see, I think, for anybody in the MCU universe. Number two, of course, following up the preview to it, which you should see before Endgame, is Captain Marvel. That is number two. It has moved up from number four, and I can see why. Because it was recommended that you see Captain Marvel first. And, of course, we find out it's the backstory of Captain Marvel. It's an origin story, and it makes effective use of the franchise's signature formula. Of course, I think it's an important movie to see. I loved it. I thought it was great. You find out where the Avengers get their name, who is Captain Marvel, how she got there. It was great. 78% tomato meter, of course. Yeah, but only 60% of the audience. Boo-hoo. Get over that. So that's what it's about. It's about the backstory of Carol Danvers and how she becomes one of the universe's most powerful heroes. Brie Larson as Carol Danvers, Captain Marvel. She is totally kicks butt in this movie. Of course, Samuel Jackson is Nick Fury. You have to see it to find out what happens to his eye, of course. Ben Mendelsohn as Talos. Lee Pace as Ronan. And Lashana Lynch as Maria Rambo. And she's very important in the movie. So go see it before you see Endgame. Absolutely. Okay, number three in the top ten is Curse of La Llorona. Now, I've heard some bad things about it. It's number three probably because of the number of people who win to give it a shot. But I've heard this was not a well-made movie. And I hated to hear that because it looked good. The critics say content to coast on jump scares rather than tap into the story's creepy potential. So they try to get away with just jump scares instead of following the story. It arrives in theaters already broken. And 31% tomato meter, 40% audience. Ouch. Not good. And this is supposed to be about 1970s LA. La Llorona is stalking the night and the children. Ignoring the eerie warning of a troubled mother suspected of child endangerment, a social worker and her own small kids are soon drawn into a frightening supernatural realm. So, and that's too bad. I really wanted that to be, that's like us, I really wanted that to be a good movie. Number four, Breakthrough. It's been 3 weeks out, and it is number four. Critics say, like its lead character, Breakthrough is fiercely focused on faith, but its less subtle elements are balanced by strong performances and an uplifting story. Hey, Ike. I better know what I'm talking about, I think. It helps a little bit. anyway, 65% tomato meter, 79% of the audience like it, so their tomato meter. Audience proved you wrong there. This is based on an inspirational true story of one mother's unfaltering love in the face of impossible odds. When Joyce Smith's adopted son falls through an icy Missouri lake, all hope seems lost. But as John lies lifeless, Joyce refuses to give up. Her belief inspires those around her to continue to pray for John's recovery, even in the face of every case, history, and scientific prediction. Chrissy Metz as Joyce Smith, and I believe she's the one in This Is Us. So, you know, good lead character there. Josh Lucas is Brian Smith. Topher Grace is Jason Noble. Mike Coulter, Tommy. Marcel Rees, John Smith. And Sam Trammell as Dr. Kent Sutterer. So, Breakthrough is number 4. 5 is Shazam. And I have not seen this, but the trailers and the reviews I have seen are absolutely fabulous. So, this is another one, a must-see, Shazam. Critics say an effortlessly entertaining blend of humor and heart, Shazam is a superhero movie that never forgets the genre's real power. 90% tomato meter, 80% audience. So, a must-see. I think I do want to see this. I've heard nothing but good about this movie. And we all have a superhero inside of us. It just takes a bit of magic to bring it out. In Billy Batson's case, by shouting out one word, Shazam, this streetwise 14-year-old foster kid can turn into the adult superhero Shazam, courtesy of an ancient wizard. He's kind of got to balance the kid adult sides. You know, we can't just have fun with this. Okay, I get you. The Mandela effect. Okay. But he's got to balance his powers in order to fight the deadly forces of evil. Zachary Levi as Shazam the adult. Mark Strong as Daddy Dr. Silvana. Asher Angel is Billy Batson, the kid. He turns into Zachary Levi. So there you go. Faith Herman is Darla. So go see Shazam. Absolutely. That is one I wanted to see. I hadn't really, until people started talking about it, then I start looking. So number 6, same in the same spot it was last week, Dumbo. And I'm really disappointed in this. And I don't know if it's because Disney rushed Tim Burton and everybody to get this movie done. I don't know. But unfortunately, it's a flop. It's held partly aloft by Tim Burton's visual flair, but a crowded canvas and overstretched story leaves this live-action remake more workmanlike than wondrous. And that's sad. It really is. That's too bad. 47% tomato meter, only 55% of the audience. So there you go. And I'm really upset. That's sad. It really is, because it could have been a really good movie. But I think they were rushed into doing it. The all-new grand live-action adventure Dumbo expands on the beloved classic story where differences are celebrated and family is cherished and dreams take flight. And it's too bad because they have a great cast. Colin Farrell is Holt, Danny DeVito, Eva Green, Michael Keaton, Alan Arkin. It's really too bad because they really have a good cast. And unfortunately, it didn't go anywhere. Number 7, Little. And this dropped a few from last week. Critics say a disappointingly uneven but overall agreeable spin on a familiar formula. Little benefits from a big heart and a story that makes good use of its well-matched cast. 46% on the tomato meter, but 72% of the audience like it. So go figure. Okay. Marseille Martin from TV's Blackish stars in and produces A Little, a comedy from producer Will Packer based on an idea the young actress pitched. The film tells the story of a woman who, when the pressures of adulthood become too much to bear, gets the chance to relive the carefree life of her younger self. So she gets to do it over. Okay. Regina Hall, Issa Rae, Marseille Martin, Tone Bell, Luke James. So, Little. Number 8 this week is Pet Sematary. I dropped one from last week. Now, I've seen mixed reviews on this. I'm going to have to see it for myself to find out what the deal is. So I'm going to have to go see this for myself. It's very mixed. If you, I don't think there's a gray area. You're either going to like it or hate it, as I'm getting from what I've seen out of the trailers and reviews on it. It's really mixed. Pet Sematary takes its source material in a few different directions, but this remake feels like an exhuming almost as often it does a revival. 58% tomato meter, only 39% of the audience. But that's only 1,700 people that voted, so that could change. I don't know. Of course, it's based on the horror novel by Stephen King. It follows Dr. Lewis Creed, who, after relocating with his wife Rachel and two young kids from Boston to Maine, discovers a mysterious burial ground hidden deep in the woods. And they set off a perilous chain reaction that unleashes an unfathomable evil with horrific consequences. We all know. Jason Clarke, Amy Semetz, Hugo Lavoie, Lucas Lavoie, John Lithgow as Judd. So I'm going to have to see it for myself to see what the deal is. Number 9, believe it or not, is still up there, Us. And I was disappointed in everybody's excuse me, review of this movie. I was hoping it was going to be better. I really was. I mean, what a premise for a movie. You meet yourselves. You're not supposed to be able to do that without dying. So, I'm like I said, I'm a little disappointed that a lot of people didn't like it. It's not as good as they built it up to be. This is Jordan Peele's second inventive, ambitious horror film. We have seen how to beat the sophomore jinx, and it is Us. 94% tomato meter. That's 94% of the reviews. 65% of the audience liked it. So that's a little better than it was. But, I mean, the premise of the movie is excellent. Finally, something different. It's too bad they couldn't pull it off. So, basically, they meet their alter egos themselves. They meet their doppelgangers. Lupita Nyong'o. I hope I'm pronouncing that right. Winston Duke, Elizabeth Moss. Evan Alex, so Us, and I'm sorry to say, I might have to see it just to see what it is. 10, Disney Nature Penguins, interesting, okay, 91% tomato meter, 70% of the audience, and that's less than 100 people that rated it, so yeah, I think it's only its first week out, so we got to give it a little time. Disney Nature Penguins plays up its subjective, adorable appeal with a beautifully filmed documentary that adds plenty of anthropomorphic, I say that 10 times, entertainment value for young viewers. Penguins, I love penguins. Okay, it's an all-new feature film. Penguins is a coming-of-age story about an Adelaide penguin named Steve, who joins millions of fellow males in the icy Antarctic spring on a quest to build a suitable nest, find a life partner, and start a family. But none of it comes easily for him, especially considering he's targeted by everything from killer whales to leopard seals, who threaten his happily ever after. Okay, and I love penguins. That'd be a cool movie just to watch. Anyway, some of the other ones. Missing Link was number 11. Hellboy, 14. I just can't. I don't like the way the guys make it. It doesn't look like Hellboy to me. I don't know. 17, How to Train Your Dragon. That should be out already. Wonder Park is still up there in the top 20. So, that is the movies. The top 10. And not a surprise, right? Not a surprise, not to me. So Tuesday will be my, I will go see it. So anyway, sorry we got started a little late tonight. I was downloading music and I lost track of time. So opening this week, let's see if they have any competition. The Intruder, Ugly Dolls, that's with Emma Roberts and Kelly Clarkson. Let's see. Savage, Tell It to the Bees. Of course, Extremely Wicked, Shockingly Evil and Vile. This is Zac Efron, This opens this weekend. We'll see how it does. A lot of people liked it that went, that I read. It's a really good, from what I've seen, it's a really good movie. It's about Ted Bundy. And Zac Efron nails it, apparently. So, there you go. Might be one to go see. Especially if you're like me, you're into the horror and the real life things like that. So, extremely wicked, shockingly evil, and vile. The Convent opens today. We'll see how that does. Meeting Gorbachev. Ask Dr. Ruth, really? Wow. those are a few. I don't think they have, I don't think Endgame has any worries this week. Coming up, RedCon 1, May 7th, next week. Pokemon Detective Pikachu opens May 10th, next weekend, with Ryan Reynolds, of course. That should be good. The Hustle with Rebel Wilson. Tolkien opens next week, I believe. Let me see, where was it? There it is. Let me see what that's about. I hope it's what I think it's about. This is explores the formative years of the renowned author's life as he finds friendship, courage, and inspiration among a fellow group of writers and artists at school. Their brotherhood strengthens as they grow up and weather love and loss together, including Tolkien's tumultuous courtship of his beloved Edith Bratt, until the outbreak of the First World War, which threatens to tear their fellowship apart. All these experiences would later inspire Tolkien to write his famous Middle-earth novels. That might be good, just to see some background on him. That would be awesome, wouldn't it? I think. So that will be opening. That might be one to go see. All is True, General Magic. The Third Wife, John Wick, Chapter 3, May 17th. Dog's Journey, May 17th. I can't watch those movies. I cry. The Unseen, May 17th. And there's a few more, but we'll get to that. Okay, let's see what DVDs. DVDs. The Man Who Killed Don Quixote. That was available last week. The Kid Who Would Be King. Also, Glass, of course, is available. Holmes and Watson with Will Ferrell and John C. Reilly. I just can't get myself to go even rent it. I just don't know with those two. I really don't. But Robert Downey Jr. is in the process of filming a new Sherlock Holmes movie. Oh, yeah. Can't wait for that. Let's see. Serenity. This past Tuesday came out. DVD. Replicas. That's been available. New releases. Let's see. I'll Take Your Dead, which was supposed to come out Thursday. They'll probably be in the stores on Tuesday. So, coming soon to DVD, How to Train Your Dragon, May 21st, couple weeks. The Lego Movie 2, the second part, that's available next week. Fighting with My Family, 2 weeks. Transit, June. Everybody Knows with Penelope Cruz next week, and Apollo 11, 2 weeks. So there you go. And those are the ones streaming also. That's about it for the movies and DVDs tonight. So yeah. I still say, Endgame, it's going to be number one for quite a while. So, Have you got to see any of the new movies, Ike? I haven't, so. Convent, that should be good. Let me see what that's about. Just, I got a few minutes here. Let me see what that's about. Of course, it's not open yet. This is in the early 17th century. Innocent young Persephone is falsely accused and put on trial for her life. Her fate seems sealed except for the timely intervention of the mysterious Reverend Mother, offering her not just sanctuary, but hope. The Reverend Mother is a self-appointed leader of a small religious sect, a secluded priory, where her fellow sisters devote their lives to the Lord and seek atonement. But upon arrival, Persephone is plagued with terrifying visions and soon realizes that's not salvation that awaits, but a battle for her soul. Who is in that? Hannah Arterton as Persephone. Claire Higgins as a Reverend Mother. Rosie Day. Michael Ironside as a magistrate. Of course, we all know Michael Ironside. Interesting. So we shall see about that one. All right. Okay. So again, as soon as I see Endgame, I will let you know. And I can read everything about it because I keep avoiding all the spoilers, of course. So don't forget, don't go away because in a bit here, Freaks in the Basement will be on with our biggest freak, Chris Stevens. Don't miss that. He plays some awesome, awesome music, so check it out. Tomorrow, join Michelle and myself for Encounters and Ecto. And that is going to, we're going to make that into a show of itself. That's going to be a show, period. We're not, it's going to be a combination, yeah, but it's going to be our own thing every other week. And then we'll do our separate shows every other week then. We'll all be good. But Ectos and Encounters will be one show. Okay, so check us out tomorrow night for that. Sunday, I'm doing part two of the dance, dance, dance music. So check it out. We're getting into some really good music now. Going to get up and dance. And I'll probably go ahead. We should have enough time. I could do the other part I've been wanting to do. It's with the electric violin and cellos. Two cellos, Brian King Joseph and Lindsey Sterling with the electric violin. So very cool. I want to get to that. So, and tomorrow night, don't forget, tomorrow night, Ike Dog, our own Ike Diaz, will have the jam. And that is a party all night long, guys. Check it out. Okay, going to hang it up. Don't forget, don't go away. Check out Freaks in the Basement. And let me see. Oh, and we have to, oh, geez. I don't know why. I would not even think of that. I can't even read anything about that. Peter Mayhew, of course, as we all know and love him, loved him as Chewbacca in the Star Wars movie, has passed away. So prayers and condolences to friends and family for that. It was a sad day when that happened. So, yeah, unfortunately, we're losing him. Losing him left and right lately. So, but anyway, the force be with you, Peter Mayhew. Okay, that does it for me for tonight. We'll see you next week on Hollywood Review. Okay, have a great night. Peace out, y'all.
Are you coming to the tree? They strung up a man, they say, who murdered three. Strange things did happen here, no stranger would it be if we met at midnight in the hanging tree. Are you coming to the tree where a dead man called out for his love to flee? Strange things did happen here, no stranger would it be if we met at midnight in the hanging tree. Are you coming to the tree where I told you to run so we'd both be free?
Strange things did happen here. No stranger would it be if we met at midnight in the hanging tree. Are you coming to the tree where necklace of hope side by side with me? Strange things did happen here. No stranger would it be if we met at midnight in the hanging tree. Are you coming to the tree where I told you to run so we'd both be free? Strange things did happen here. No stranger would it be if we met at midnight in the hanging tree. Are you coming to the tree? They strung up a man, they say you're a threat.